Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hi, I'm Indu Gilang Pratama. I'm from Biology Education of Ring B, Universitas Negeri Malang, 2019. Here I will present about my article. The title is Deep Sea Fish Expand Their Stomach to Hold Hug Meals. This article I got from the National Geographic. So, let's see. The first adept. Many species have evolved ways to thaw their own nourishment and adaptation to environmental. That is why some species have developed unique strategies to prevent hunger. For the example, they store their food in their bodies or store it in a certain place so as not run out of food. The first creatures is plague swallowers. The plague swallowers is a deep sea fish that takes on much bigger prey and then lungs around its digesting meal in a stomach that hangs below, a bit like grocery bags. The plague swallowers live in the depth of up to 2.5 meters, where food is relatively scarce. Perhaps why the plague swallowers eat so much as a cat eat while you can strategize and in the little populated it in the little populated deep the fish can take time to digest this larger prey items without fear of being menaced. And in the next slide you will see the plague swallower's fish. You can see in here the stomach. This fish stomach is bigger than their body. Yeah, you can see the fish is very scary, right? Okay. And then the next creatures is chipmunk. Chipmunk can carry nuts or seeds that have been collected in their mouths. So the chipmunk was hug chicks or just hold nuts or seeds gathered during the warmer month rather than riding up for the long winter. There's 25 species of chipmunk in their collecting chicks. Chipmunk gather nuts or seeds in their mouth before they bury them in the safe place. And then in the next slide, you will see chipmunk. Now, chipmunk in here is the chipmunk in here are collected the nuts before they bury them to the safe place. You can see they will eat the nuts or seeds maybe, and they store at their mouth before they bury them in the safe place. Okay, next. And the next creatures we had honeypot ants. Honeypot ants live in the arid climates around the world, including Australia, Southern Africa, and Mexico. During drought and the dry season, some of the ants supporting the colony by growing their own honeypots. The special ants called Repetulus. And these ants fill themselves up with nectar, sap, and sugary substance. This sugary substance called honeydew, which is secreted by another type of insect, that is aphid. The ants eat until the back of their bodies swell with the sweet stuff. Then the insect will hang from the ceiling of their underground colonies and and then they recreate the liquid to feed hungry. To feed a hungry housemates, yeah, the hungry housemates. In the next, you will see the end. Nah, look the back from the ends. Is that bigger than the bodies? Yeah, the back bodies from this end is filled by nectar, sap, and what? Yeah, there is. So after they fill their back bodies with nectar, they will back to the nest and feed the housemates. Their housemates. Sorry. Okay. The next creature is pelicans. Like kid who eats all the candy before getting home, pelicans don't store fish in their hook bill pouch, but swallow them pretty quickly. Their pouches are mostly full of water, which they tilt their head back and allow to drain before swallowing their food. Most of the seven pelicans found worldwide except for the Antarctica is the pelican is collective to the pelican is collective to eat the fish by swimming in a line or a group and herding pet fish together. And in the next slide you will see this pelican's picture. They will eat fish by swimming on a line or by a group, and they eat together. They eat fish, ice, and then the last creatures is pitcher plants. Neplandus genus of pitcher plant, native to Southeast Asia and the northernmost tip of Australia, has a pitcher shaped leaf that serves to trap insects, salamander, and even small mammals. Some of species pitchers have mosslet coloring that look a bit like tasty carrion which lures the prey inside the pitchers. The cup slippery sides and producing up then ensures with falls in and doesn't make it out. And then the bottom of this plant is there is a disgustive fluids in there when the prey down and fall into the cup, the prey drown and decomposes, an ability this carnivorous plant to thrive the nutrient. And the next slide you will see the carnivore plant. Yeah, the shape is like a cup, so the insect can fall into the cups, so the plant can eat it. Okay, I think that is all of my presentation. I hope you enjoy it, and thanks for the attention. Bye. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Dah.